私の胸で泣き崩れてもいいよ。あなたの心を絡ませて。I am heading to lunch right now and I'm meeting a friend. Machine knitting always goes by super quickly and I only got to do one sample. We have two swatches to do, but I didn't have time to start on the second one yet. I found out the last week that the machine knitting studio closes at 11, so I might go there after my class tonight and just finish up that sample. It smells so good. Right now, I have a bit of time before my bag making class. I think today we're starting on pattern making for our first bag design. I sketched this out yesterday. The first bag that we're doing is, well, it's basically just a zip top pouch. I have this problem with over designing and I did not think about how I would actually make these bags when I was drawing them out. Like, I kind of did. I thought about all the details and the materials, but I didn't realize how little time we had to make all our products. Yeah, I definitely do not want to show up with nothing completed. If spring is the season that wakes me alive, then fall is the season to contemplate life. Oh, I don't know what is it exactly in this time of year that makes the melancholy me reappear. Oh, back and forth through dark roads, coffee, salt, mystery, sea, sand, and amber trees. Cause it still feels like summer, but it's soaked in nostalgia slowly. All the leaves are turning brown. Cause it still feels like summer, and I simply so I just finished my bag class. I'm exhausted. I said earlier that I was gonna go to the knitting studio, but I can't. After cutting all that leather, just thinking about going to the knitting machines and then having to once again use my non-existent arm muscles, that does not sound fun. If my professors allow it, I'm going to use the laser cutter to cut out my pattern pieces for future projects. I just want to say I am so grateful for my professors this semester because they are all just amazing, and this is the first semester since I've entered Parsons where I've had all decent professors, and the difference it makes having good professors, it's all the difference in the world. I saw this girl in school carrying this Balenciaga bag today and it literally stopped me in my tracks. I'm obsessed with it. Can we talk about how Balenciaga has been slaying the game lately? Everything, their campaigns, their bags, everything besides their clothing, in my opinion. And like the campaigns that they're doing involving the environment, I think it's so cool. And even their last show, like the whole blizzard. Comment your thoughts down below about Balenciaga. I want to know what you guys think about them right now. Do you like them? Do you not like them? I was thinking about getting an internship for the fall semester, and I've been browsing our school's job site and I came across a few interesting ones. And so yesterday I was fixing up my resume and this morning I put together a little portfolio to apply with. I feel like doing product this semester, I have a little bit more time that I could get a job and I won't be super overwhelmed. Whenever I think about applying to jobs or like just my career in general, it always makes me feel some type of way and I get a teeny bit anxious. Often I feel really underqualified, but I'm not gonna let this fear of feeling not good enough stop me, and I'm just gonna try and put myself out there and hope for the best. I kind of have a good feeling though. Like, I feel like I might be able to snag a job. Hey, you guys. I just finished up my first internship interview and it went pretty well. I think I secured the spot. Yeah, very excited because this is a new opportunity for me and can't wait to just grow myself as a designer, learn more and more and more. I will keep you guys updated, bring you guys on the journey, and yeah, we will be interns together. I cut this egg open. Look at the yolk. So teeny tiny. Made myself a little salad for lunch. I actually have one more internship interview today. It's in person in the NoHo area, which is near school. So after that interview, I think I'm gonna go to school. I'm gonna go to the knitting studio to finish the swatch that I said I would do on Monday but never got around to. And then for the longest time, I've been meaning to do some thing with these couch pillows that I have because really they're just bland. I was experimenting with making a little pillowcase for it and I made this little knit sample. I did a ladder design, which is basically a fake rib, but this was done like probably 2 weeks ago, and since then I've learned a lot more new techniques. So the plan for today is to create some pillowcase designs and try them out in knitting studio. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, I love it.
I like the black one. You can also like flip it upwards as well, and then wear it like that.
Oh, like the ear. Stop. I kind of love it. I love big showrooms like this, especially when there's nobody around and it's just me. It's just so calming and there's like no pressure to buy anything. You can just walk around, browse, get inspiration. It's just so fun. I just finished up my interview. It was so cool to see. Their studio is so pretty and cute, and I definitely want to be a part of that team. I don't think the lady that was interviewing me really liked me too much. I don't know, I can't really tell with her. You know, if it's meant to be, it'll be, and if not, then yeah, whatever. I also really want to make sure that I don't overwhelm myself and I don't let having an internship take over my life and distract me from school, because school is definitely my first priority still. The internship requires like 20 hours a week, which honestly is a lot, and they were kind of asking for a lot. So I don't know, I just hope I'm not overloading my plate with too much. I always know that. Hey. You ain't gotta make a fuss. When I was down, out of luck, and you stuck. It was us in a rut. Woke up, I hit a chick for you. Baby, give me life, you know I live for you. Ride or die, kill for you. Let them talk slick, I'ma have to split a wig for you. Where you grab my chain, got me feeling like Jibs on you. You know I'm here for you. Baby, if you ever try to leave, I'ma beg, I'ma
shedding tears for you. Let me shed a tear for you. Whisper in your ear, let me make it real clear. You gon' always know that I'ma keep it chill with you.
I'ma keep it chill with you.
I'ma keep it straight one.
All right, so imagine you've had a long day of work, of school, whatever. You've had a long day. You come home, open the door, and this is what you see. The sun is setting. It's casting a golden glow over the entire city. Seriously, every day I get home, like I walk through my door, and I am so grateful to be where I am, to have what I have. All the problems, everything bad that happened doesn't really seem to matter anymore. I know I probably sound like really cheesy and stuff right now. Please don't clown me, okay? I'm just in a really good mood right now. So I was able to successfully finish just a panel for my pillowcase, and it looks so good. I was designing as I was knitting, didn't really plan anything, was playing around with pleats. They're just so cute. And then I also blended together a few different yarns. I feel like everything kind of matches, the black with the frames and my paintings, and then the stripes beigey color matches with my couch. I think it looks pretty good. Oh my gosh. I told myself I would stop eating out, so I went on a Trader Joe's grocery run yesterday, and I got mostly healthy stuff, but I also got this, I think it's either barbecue chicken or buffalo chicken pizza, which looks super good, and it smells amazing, by the way.
Because usually what I do
from this, we'll decide on three.
Yeah, that's the app. I agree.
Today, after we take this picture, we'll decide on this.
Okay. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Grabbing Thai food for lunch. This is honestly my favorite Thai place.
Really?
I haven't tried that much.
Again, like most things, lefty loosey, righty tighty, that's the
just like one swipe across. Kind of started this little tradition where every Friday after school, after classes, we'll meet up and do all our homework, as much work as we can. No, but you know, like when you already did something but you write it down just so you can cross it out.
Not sufficient.
Basically, we had to pick an image and then make like a pattern based on that image. So this is my image, and then this is the pattern that I'm doing. Just planned it out right now, but then probably this weekend I'm gonna go to knitting studio and try to execute this plan and see how it turns out.
No way.